On behalf of the Jewish Federation of Edmonton, I am so excited to be able to share with you our Mosaic Art Project that was made possible through a microgrant for shining a light on antisemitism through the Jewish Federations of North America. We were able to engage individual community members in creating a mosaic piece of art that gave full expression to their experiences and impacts of Jew hatred and antisemitism. We were thrilled to have local artist Lewis Lavoie work with us to be able to bring these voices together in a culminating piece of mosaic art. We also are going to have it continue to live on with a virtual reality tour that people can engage with by zooming in on particular tiles and having interactive videos to explain from the first person, from the people who actually made those tiles themselves.
My name is Lewis Lavoie. I am a graphic artist, a painter, and a visual artist. I started to get into mosaics, like doing a mosaic mural, using a diversity of artists and different people in order to tell one story, but yet let everyone tell their individual stories. I believe every human being is creative.
The human spirit comes through in that creative process. We engaged with various institutions and had events that people could come out and create these tiles to express the impact of antisemitism on them personally.
Everybody's got a place at the table to say something. These murals actually work really well when you got that camaraderie and everybody's like working together.
And it allowed people to really think about what they were doing and what they wanted to express about themselves on their tiles and have those conversations as they were creating them.
I kind of see the metaphor as being like it's you want to work with your neighbor.
In order to fight antisemitism, it's best to come together like we are today.
Like the community is made up of a mosaic of people, right? And that was one of the biggest things I wanted to work with is diversity. A lack of diversity, there seems to be a lack of tolerance and a lack of acceptance. That's what brings about antisemitism. It brings about any kind of hatred towards another group of people.
Coming out of the darkness to talk about antisemitism and people's experience of Jew hatred was very cathartic, in particular our teens who've experienced for the first time some of these expressions on social media and engaged with people in very difficult conversations. This was an event that allowed them to have their voices heard and to be able to sit and have some very impactful conversation with our local leaders, including our Mayor Sohi.
You know, it was really nice to connect with some of the kids who are doing the painting. One thing that they experience when they experience anti-Semitism is fear. Fear of denial of their identity and fear of being stuck. You know, that's what we've been talking about, like how fear can actually cripple people's ability to, be part of the community.
Basically, this is about being open-minded and willingness to learn and understand and respect other people, religion and culture.
I mean, anti-Semitism, it just always feels like it's in the background, you know, bubbling and boiling. Being a non-Jew, I feel a connection to it somehow.
No matter how much you talk about it, it's not enough. And it keeps rearing its ugly head. So yes, we've got to keep talking about it, we've got to keep thumping at it, no matter how much people say we're sick and tired of hearing about it, it's not enough.
We've always lived with anti-Semitism, but it's on the rise, and we need to share our experiences and our grandparents' experiences. My grandparents are no longer alive, so as a granddaughter of a survivor, it's my job to tell their stories.
I saw some people were writing words of hope and love, and other people were writing things of fear and pain, and I thought, when I encounter anti-Semitism, it makes me feel defiant, like I want to fight back. I mean, I want to fight back against many things all the time, but this one in particular.
Some of the expressions on those tiles, the grief, the fear, the anger that people have felt. At the same time, there are great expressions of positivity and hope and optimism for our ability to get to know one another on a very personal level and work together for the betterment of society.
I get these murals in pieces. Tikkun Olam. It's like the world is broken and we're putting it together. And even when it's put together, I like to see the fact that you can see gaps in between the tiles and that it's not perfectly put back together. There's still a a part of it that's cracked and broken a little bit. I believe that's the full charm of these murals.
This project gives me great hope for the conversations we can continue to have and how we continue to shine a light on anti-Semitism.